Hello everyone, Daniel here from the Next Issue Podcast. On today's video, I'll be doing a review for Immortal X-Men number 4. Oh my god, I'm loving this series. It is so much fun. Everything that's going on with the X-Men this week has been so amazing. If you haven't read or seen our reviews for the Hellfire Gala, go check that out. This book takes place before that, but you can read them in either order. So let's take a look at the creative team before I get deeper into this book. So part 4, Diamonds Are Forever, is written by Karen Gillan with art by Michelle Bendini, David Coriel on colors, Clayton Kyle on letters, with a beautiful cover by Mark Brooks, as well as some variant covers that we will see towards the end of the video. So in this issue, a gala performance, Emma Frost will do anything to protect the children, including the metaphorical child that is the Hellfire Gala. Last year's was a fantastic success. It really was. It was a fun party. She would not like it if someone ruined the second. She would not like it at all, but don't worry. I'm sure it'll all go fine. I love the meta of some of these synopses for the books or the solicitations for the summary. So one really cool thing that happens here, and let me pull up some preview art. We find out that Emma Frost, and this is something like, you never really think about some stuff, or maybe some people do, that she sleeps in her diamond form because it is the way that she kind of shields herself against the world, whether it be from a psychic attack while she's sleeping, a physical attack, right? Because her diamond form is pretty much indestructible. But all that stuff can really protect her from some of her insecurities and all that stuff. Really, really cool stuff. I think the art team really captures that stuff. And I love the narration all throughout this because Karen Gillan's really giving us an in-depth look at inside of the workings of Emma Frost. She's such a cool character. She's such a compelling character. And I love that she's been kind of getting her due more in the more recent years. She's such a linchpin for all the stuff that's been happening since House of X and Powers of 10. So yeah, we pretty much spend the whole issue with her. We do see here that right before the gala, somebody poured blood on Emma Frost, because now that the secret is out about mutant immortality, humans obviously they believe that the mutants are not sharing that with the world. So yeah, really cool stuff. And I love these transition panels here as she's kind of realizing what happened, looking at herself in the mirror, and she turns into the diamond form. Because that is where she can't get hurt, right? And then we do go see some stuff with the Quiet Council as they try to figure out what their next step is. Because now that the secret is out, do they want to go on with the party? So really, really fun stuff. I am so much enjoying this era of X-Men, this Destiny of X part of the story. It's a lot of fun. Like I said, the Hellfire Gala issue was so much fun too. We also saw the Eve of Judgment Day book that is a preamble to the Judgment Day event that also Karen Gillan will be writing. So yeah, everything's coming together. Stay tuned to the channel for more coverage, because we'll definitely be talking about all that stuff. And as always, thanks for watching, everyone. Remember to share, like, subscribe, hit the bell so you know when we go live. That is most Sundays, 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. Stay tuned, because we have more comic reviews, trailer reactions, TV recaps, all that fun stuff here in the channel. And I'll leave you with a look at some of those beautiful variants, including some by Phil Noto and some of the Hellfire Gala variants that we have. So thanks for watching, everyone. Bye-bye.